In the past decade or so, arguments against competitive attitudes have arisen. They say it breeds hostility, and that it takes what was once fun and turns it into a battleground. But these are the arguments of the zebra. So what of the lion, those who seek to compete and to win? The world would not be the one that the zebra so enjoys if not for the lion. Don't believe me? Let me tell you about a little thing called the space race. The Second World War had just ended, but a new kind of war was only beginning. The Cold War. But it was more than just a nuclear arms race. It was a massive culture war. Which was better? USA? USSR? Capitalism? Communism? We couldn't just look it up back then, so I had to be proved through sheer accomplishment. And it is that that spawned the space race. How high of a priority do you think space travel was for the government before 1945, with things like roads and wars on the docket? But as soon as we heard that the Reds were on their way to that circle in the sky, it suddenly became a priority. That need for victory, that need to crush the adversary and prove superiority, drove the USA and Soviet Union to make great strides in their space programs and make technological developments that would have taken decades longer without the space race. Competition bred innovation like nothing else would. The spirit of innovation thrives today in our schools through the Technology Student Association, wherein young people can test their abilities to outperform their peers in a series of technologically based events in a competitive yet cooperative environment. So, which are you? A zebra in a box, satisfied with mediocrity? Or are you a lion, seeking the thrill of the fight and the sweet taste of victory? Do you think yourself clever? Do you see within yourself the drive to outwork and the wit to outplay? If so, then to you, I have only one thing left to say. T.S.A.